French fries, burgers, pizza, chicken, milkshakes, hot dogs, sandwiches, milkshakes, hot dogs, sandwiches.
Hey folks, Crazyclimber80 here and Coach Shiley over there, and we are just outside, well, not just outside, but around the corner from a place called Sure Shot Burgers.
It is.
Yeah.
S-H-O-R-E. Basically, it's...
I don't remember seeing it spelled like that.
Platypus Ice Skate is where we're at, because it's the same thing. It's just taking liberal fucking approach at how you're going to pronounce words, since fuck English.
Yeah, well, yeah, English sure. is garbage.
S-U-R-E is actually pronounced sure.
Yeah, a lot of people
no,
call
actually,
it sure.
No, nobody does, actually.
No, you're a fool.
Yeah, exactly. You don't go swimming at this burger spot, and there are no sharks. You're not in danger of a shark attack.
Please ignore him.
Yeah.
He is
sorry
full of
for
himself.
Being fucking accurate.
No, he's...
Anyway, his opinion means jack shit.
Whatever. Anyway, this...
But at least I'm here to be the reason, the voice of reason and truth. Truth, justice, and free checking. Anyway, to Sure Shot Burgers.
These are smash burgers. These are, well...
Yeah, they're little tiny little fuckers. I mean, you can see our little hoobity-hoobies right over here.
Wrapping there.
That is a double burger.
Yes. It's not very big. It doesn't look like it's a double, but it is.
Yeah, so...
Like I said, they're smash burgers, so they're flat. Flat patties, a little crispy around the edge.
You got some fucking Thousand Island on there, secret sauce action.
Some like that, yeah.
Lots of little fucking diced up onions as far as that part goes.
Yeah, it looks like something you get from a cafeteria.
Yep,
it doesn't look great, but
special sauce top and bottom.
I've actually had these before and they are very tasty.
Pretty fucking simple. Pretty simple critters.
This is Beaverton, Oregon. Almost Shoals and Allen.
Yeah, Shoals and Allen. There's a fucking growler house / brew pub / fucking whatever next to a mechanic shop. And this is just a little food cart sitting out in front. There's like 4 parking spots, so you have to park on the street, but that's okay. Yeah. It seems like it's a pretty busy little spot, but
yeah, they get
it's a
business.
Very limited menu. It's just regular, double, or a Fig Jam Burger.
And then there's Cadillac Fries, which we'll get to in just a second. And then there's Brussels Sprouts.
Yes. And then you get sauces. There are the special sauce, which looks like McDonald's sauce, whatever. A garlic mayo and then a spicy ketchup. And then let me show you, the good people, what the Brussels Sprouts. They look pretty fucking good. And actually, the dude at the front taking the order said that they're fantastic, which I'm guessing you probably wouldn't say, oh, no, dude, those are dog shit. Don't order them. We'll find out. I really like Brussels sprouts, but it has this doesn't appear to have bacon, but it is peppers and onions, shallots. Maybe that is a piece of bacon. I can't fucking tell. No, it's not. But anyway, I'll try those after the burger action. But
okay.
Anyway.
So yeah, he kind of showed earlier. Here, let me get another close up.
Yeah, I'm gonna turn that on too. I don't know why it turned off on us, but we may need a little lighting.
Okay, yeah, but yeah, that it does not look like much. The pickles look like good, healthy slices.
Yes.
But I've had this before, and it is tasty. The sauce that they put on here is really good, from what I remember.
A little special sauce, and then why don't you give them a quick little
and
fucking
then we'll
view
look at the Cadillac fries. I don't know what makes this, why they call this Cadillac. Does not look like a car.
No, it does not.
But it is fries with a
curly fries
with a goopy kind of nacho-y cheese.
Yeah, it looks like nacho cheese, some green onions, and then some fucking
and some pickled onions.
Yeah, pickled reds. It looks like
pickled red onions,
which fucking phenomenal.
And I've had this before, and I remember it being very good. But we will get to that in a moment.
Let's dig
but first,
in here.
Burger time.
Two super thin patties, but they are flat topped, so you can see there's a good amount of texture to that to the meat. A little crispy.
Nice
probably.
wide patties. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like these.
Very simple.
Very simple.
Dude, the pickle is really good.
Yeah, the pickle's good.
Which is a weird thing to say. Oh, that's a really good pickle in there.
Yeah. And the sauce, I think, is what really, really helps sell it. Yet you might not really get into it in first bite.
Then I'm not sure why the Jeep is possessed with the light.
Yeah, I was
going to
say, is that a time delight or what's going on?
And there's a side to this little fucking, was it garlic mayo? Was that what it was?
Yeah, I think it was.
Let's try a little of that shit on there.
Mmm. The sauce makes me think of, God damn it. The Helvetia Tavern or the other place that has similar tasting burgers.
Do you want to try some of that? And it's not heavy garlic at all. It's actually a little bit lighter sauce. Interesting.
Maybe in a minute. What was the burger place that gets all the renown around Portland? God damn it.
Well, you gone to Helvetia Tavern. You love that place. I think it's massively overrated.
No, I think it's similar to... God damn it, what's the other one? The other big one in Northeast Portland? They used to have one.
Stanish?
Stanish's. Yeah.
See, the Stanish one is got a lot of mustard to the sauce, which sucks. Hey, we should tell these people, hey, just keep your lights on just like that. It makes me look like Jesus.
No.
So the Stanish one. I would have to throw a bunch of fucking ketchup on my burger so it didn't just sit there and taste mustard.
It has a little bit of mustardy taste.
It's heavy mustard. This one's not like that, I don't think. It's not like a traditional Thousand Island, though. I actually like throwing this little fucking kind of, I think they said it was garlic mayo, but it's, they said it's very light. It's almost more like, or it almost tastes
dab
more.
Dab a little on the top here. I'm gonna dip into it. Yeah. Let's see what that's like.
Pretty light, actually.
Not too bad. It's almost like ranch.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. It's like a little bit of... There is a little garlic to it, but it's lighter like a ranch, not like a regular mayo to where it's just heavy, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a big fan of fucking saucy burgers. So whether it's like I said, with a traditional motherfucker burger, I like a bunch of ketchup in it. I just always have. I don't know. And I think that the ketchup plays well with the egg, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Even though ketchup on breakfast itself is for fucking trash human beings.
Yeah, I really like the sauce on this burger. These are good.
Mm-hmm. And relatively cheap. So, I mean, these are itty-bitty burgers. Don't get me wrong. Good. I'm actually, when you told me about them the first time, I wasn't uber thrilled about it. You know, it's like, oh, okay, they're a fucking trash burger. But far surpasses my expectation.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty cheap. These are $8. So, I mean, I guess that's actually not that cheap at all. It's
well,
good.
In today's
it's
economy,
good, though, right? Yeah. Hey, yeah. At least it costs more and our money doesn't go nearly as far as it used to. So that's good.
Yours is the open one?
That yours is
the
open one.
What I was thinking.
But I would be interested in trying the fucking fig burger. As disgusting as it sounds, but it's like, that's so weird. It has to be
good.
You have
to try it once. You have to try it once.
Or at least a bite.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe you should just get yourself a burger and then just crumble fig Newtons over it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but then if you did that, you'd be like, man, it would be better if it was the strawberry Newtons instead.
Yeah. Or some of the... Didn't they briefly have a grape Newton?
No idea. There were apple, I know.
There was cherry Newtons for a short time, too.
Yeah, those are fucking... Dude, I haven't had a Fig Newton in like 20 years.
Yeah, but it,
here's a fucking fork for you, Dick Smack.
Oh.
I'm guessing you want that with your broken fucking wrist.
Eh. For the most part, it feels all right. It's just a couple spots.
That's what Maya said.
When something happened?
Well, that feels all right.
I wouldn't know.
What happens in Beaverton stays in Beaverton, is that what you're saying?
Idiot. Anyway.
Ruh-roh.
Did you want to keep working on that, or did
I haven't even tried yet.
Okay.
We're going to see. Okay, so. God damn it. Yeah. There we go. We're back on. So, again, interesting. There's some kind of a fucking, maybe sour cream type sauce. A bunch of fucking little peppers. There are jalapenos in it as well. Because I'm a big fan of doing Brussels sprouts up, right? Doing it pan-fried and all that kind of stuff. Because Goober's never had them that way and never will because he won't try them. But
no.
Most people have had Brussels sprouts only steamed, and they're fucking awful that way.
Yes.
Texture sucks and they stink. But if you do it properly, do some balsamic, all that kind of good shit in there, it's a pretty fucking good veggie as far as vegetables go. What I'll say on these is it's the right idea and poorly executed. You don't get any kind of a texture because they're steamed, obviously steamed, then hit in the pan, but I think that they likably have been sitting in they probably did one batch or whatever and keep them hot or warm, you know? They need something high heat to give you some crispiness, some texture in there. It could also probably need some bacon. That's one of the things you need with the Brussels sprout. Give it some fat content instead of just the fucking sour cream. But I like all the little peppers in here.
It is on a timer.
Mm-hmm. Well, it doesn't. It's helping you to not kill your fucking battery.
Yeah, it's just really short.
But increments. Yeah, it just fuck. That's what my girlfriends have all said about me. But but yeah, it's these are worthwhile. Not worth the fucking $8. If they were properly executed, I'd be all over it at $8. But it needs bacon. But I've never thought of putting peppers with Brussels sprouts, and they do work. It brings you the acidity that I would have from adding balsamic vinegar myself. But
so while you're still working on that, I'll just go ahead and dive in a little
bit. Get started, yeah.
Yeah, like I said.
I'm guessing you didn't want any. Holy fuck.
No.
Let there be light.
Yeah.
All right, what do you think there, dickface?
About the fries?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah,
No, I meant about the fucking World Series.
Well, I don't freaking know. Are you talking about me, or are you talking about the people that are shining their, trying to blind us?
I'm talking to the people for you.
Okay.
Okay.
Anyway, yeah, no, I've had these before. Yeah. I really like these. I like the sauce, and I like the pickled onions on this.
Okay, so the first thing I'll notice is that they do crisp up the fries well. That's that's essential.
Yeah, and again, I'm not sure why they call these Cadillac fries.
Because it's got all the shit on it.
That's not helping.
Well, like top shelf, so like a top shelf margarita is called a Cadillac margarita.
No, I'm not a mixologist. So,
yeah, these are good. These really are good. Okay, so you know what this, and neither of us are huge fans of, but the tomatoes make this.
Yeah, that's a
weird thing.
Yeah, they're not big. I can have tomatoes on things, but I need them to be small.
A little tomato, and then the fucking pickled onions. Mm-hmm. Those are good, man. Another thing that could use bacon in there as well.
Bacon always works on anything.
No, but the two things that bacon's going to bring, give you a little smokiness, right? You don't need the fat from the bacon, but the smokiness to it, and give you that little extra bit of fucking texture with it.
Yeah, I still.
But I like these. These are really good. These are better than the fucking Brussels. And a dollar cheaper.
I would hope so.
And a dollar cheaper.
Yeah, I really like these. The anytime you see a nacho sauce and it looks like somebody just ralphed all over your fries,
then it's gonna taste good.
It'll often be surprisingly good, and that's the case with these.
Yeah, even though it looks like you just went to 7-Eleven and used their nacho machine.
Mm-hmm. Which I don't know that you can these days.
Yeah, shut down for the COVID diseases.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, Jesus would want us to have nacho cheese.
Jesus would want us to have our freedoms back.
Yeah, freedom to withhold fucking convenience store fucking toppings.
Mm-hmm.
Should be one
of the Ten Commandments.
I think it was the 11th. Just missed the cut.
And then was it Mel Brooks? Dropped it.
Yeah. These 20 commandments. These 10 commandments. Oh, which, I don't know if you saw, History of the World Part 2 is coming out.
What?
Yes. Because they made the first one. Right, never and actually there were
plans.
The second.
There were plans to make the second.
They had the trailer at the end of it. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a TV series produced by Mel Brooks.
Well, hopefully they will have Hitler on Ice.
No shit, right? Yeah, I gotta watch the History of World 1 again. That's been a minute.
It wasn't great, great.
Oh, it was funny. It was funny. It had its moments.
Mm.
Yeah, so that was worthwhile. I guess the recap on this, worthwhile. For being a little bullshit fucking food cart sitting in front of a tap house.
I was impressed.
It's much better than I anticipated it being.
I like the sauces that they put on the fries and the burgers. I think it really, really makes, that and the pickled onions on these fries, all really, really strong.
Mm. See, it would be worthwhile if you asked him to put the pickled onions on the burger, too. That would be good, too.
Yeah.
Right. But again, it's very simple. It's not a whole lot different than you'd make at your own fucking house. You know what I mean? Like it's, they are very simple burgers.
They are.
They're smash patties. I mean, they're fucking paper thin.
Yeah, but they're wide.
You get a good little texture to them.
Mm-hmm.
Simple fucking ingredients. The place is fucking packed, right? And it still only took 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Like we walked from here down the street to the fucking Plaid Pantry to get our little RC action. Turned around, came right back. and the food was ready.
Yeah, they are very efficient, very.
But then again, this is kind of like fucking In-N-Out, right? In-N-Out only has burgers, fries,
yeah, very
drink shake.
Menu.
That's it. So you can crank everything out and you keep everything fresh and keep everything good.
Mm-hmm.
Very similar idea here.
Mm-hmm.
But success anyway.
Yeah, very good. And yeah, they definitely get their business.
Yeah, worthwhile.
Yep.
But anyway, folks, I think this is it for us.
I think that'll do it. That's two reviews in one day, and since he
lives, we get another one in tomorrow. Although it is a fucking 2-hour round trip for me to fucking make it out here. I do it for the art. I do it for you people.
That's right.
Anywho, until next time, and that may be less than 24 hours away.
Might be.
Well, adios.
We'll see you on the flip side, folks.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Fade out. French fries.